Hello, everyone, and welcome to the September 2025 Sky Report. My name is Vanessa, and I'm here today with Patrick.
Hello, stargazers.
Let's see what's happening in the skies this month.
Our first event this month is the continuation of the Titan shadow transit season. From the night of September 3rd to the morning of the 4th, Titan's shadow will move across Saturn's northern hemisphere. At 10:27 p.m., the shadow will be visible on the planet's left edge. An 8-inch telescope at 200 magnification or a 10-inch telescope at 250 magnification should offer a clear view of Titan's shadow, particularly on nights with excellent atmospheric conditions. By 12:15 a.m., the shadow will be positioned at the top center of the planet. The transit ends at 1:45 a.m. The second shadow transit of the month occurs on the night of September 19th, starting at 10:12 p.m. This time, Titan will appear very close to its shadow. Mid-transit occurs at 11:12 p.m. Titan may be difficult to spot against Saturn's cloud tops. The transit ends at 12:18 a.m.
On September 13th, we will observe a lunar standstill northern moonrise. Throughout 2023 to now in 2025, Griffith Observatory has been following the lunar standstill phenomenon that only happens every 18.6 years. During this two-year time period, the moon's orbit is tilted in a way that allows for extremely far north and extremely far south moonrises and moonsets on our horizon, and extremely low and high travel paths in our sky. The lunar standstill season is approaching its end very soon, but you still have a few more chances to observe one of these events. We have also broadcasted many of these events in the past 2 years. You may visit our website to learn more about what exactly the lunar standstill is and why it happens, and to find our previous and upcoming broadcasts. To observe this moonrise yourself, you only need your eyes and maybe a compass to tell you which direction is northeast. That same evening at 4:30 a.m. on the 14th, the moon will approach one of the brighter stars in Taurus, Alnath. This is only possible during the lunar standstill season because of the location of the star, Alnath. The moon will not pass in front of the star, but you can watch with a pair of binoculars to see these two objects less than a degree apart from each other. The last standstill event for the day is to watch as the moon travels high in the sky, reaching its midpoint after sunrise at about 6:50 a.m. The moon will be about 84 degrees above the horizon. That's nearly directly above, and is about 5 degrees higher than the summer solstice sun. Before sunrise on September 19th, the very small 5% waxing crescent moon sits low on the eastern horizon with the very bright planet Venus and bright star Regulus in Leo the Lion. This will be visible with just your eyes, but you'll need a clear horizon. Look for them by 5:30 a.m. before they are washed out by the rising sun. Binoculars will offer a closer view of the thin crescent moon. On September 22nd, autumn officially begins as the sun passes through the celestial equator during the autumnal equinox.
Saturn's opposition occurs on September 21st, when the Earth is directly between the sun and Saturn, making the planet appear especially bright and visible in the night sky. This event happens roughly every 378 days. On this day, Saturn will be about 796 million miles from Earth. Now, let's take a look at what constellations we'll see this month. The eastern sky is dominated by the autumn constellations. Pegasus, the flying horse, is marked by four stars, forming the distinctive Square of Pegasus. Behind it trails Andromeda, with Perseus following low in the east. Above Perseus, the W shape of Cassiopeia stands out brightly.
To the south, we can see Scorpius and its bright star Antares setting on the southwestern horizon. Aquila stays high in the sky, along with its bright star Altair. Low in the southeast is the bright star Fomalhaut, found in Pisces Astrinus.
In the western sky, the bright late summer stars Vega and Outer drift towards the horizon, setting in the early hours of the morning. Meanwhile, the constellations Sagittarius, Hercules, and Bootes dip below the horizon much earlier.
Let's take a look at what the planets are doing this month. To start off, we have Jupiter and Venus on the eastern horizon before the sun rises. Venus starts out low in the constellation of Cancer, and Jupiter sits between the twins in Gemini. By the middle of the month, on the 15th, Venus sinks lower in the sky, heading towards Leo the Lion. Jupiter starts to slip east of Gemini, but remains in the constellation. By the end of the month, Venus is too low to be observed as it makes its way to the other side of the Sun. Jupiter stays in the constellation of Gemini and rises higher in the sky with the constellation.
Throughout this month, Saturn will be visible in the eastern sky during the evening. It will be well positioned for observation, staying visible all night long. Saturn is in retrograde motion throughout the month, located in the constellation Pisces the Fishes. Around the middle of the month, Mars can be seen low in the west-southwest during the fading twilight. By month's end, it will be obscured by the sun's glare.
And here is your lunar calendar for the month. Full moon is on the 7th. The last quarter is on the 14th. The new moon is on the 21st. And the first quarter is on the 29th.
Thank you so much for joining us for September, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and watch our Lunar Standstill broadcasts. We'll see you next month.
Bye.